Social media has been getting a really bad rap lately, and I wanted to talk a little bit about that. You know, people keep saying that social media is destroying society, right? It's making people negative and hateful. It's polarizing people. It's making people depressed. And what I found odd is that that's not how it affects me. And I thought a little bit about it just now. I was just thinking, you know, why is that? Why do I have a positive experience on social media when so many people are reporting the opposite? And I figured it out. I figured it out how I beat it. And I honestly think that if this is something that you think is affecting you, I think that if you think about it this way, I think it can change maybe your life. Like, it'll change the way you spend your time online. So it's really two things that I do. First one is super obvious. The second one isn't. Okay, so the first thing that I do is engage with less negative, polarizing content. Now, I know, like I said, it's super obvious. But this is step one. Not only does this break the system, because if people just stop clicking this crap and commenting on this crap, it would no longer be profitable to publish that crap, and the system would be fixed. But that'd be high aspirations that I don't think is realistic. The main reason that you want to do this is because there's a tail to what you do online. So if you're engaging with with something polarizing, it's going to be polarizing to other people, which means if you give your opinion, someone else is going to give their opinion, and it becomes a very toxic place very quickly. So step one is just avoiding the game that these companies have you in, right? There's a point when, you know, social is a lot healthier place, and it's not now. Well, why is that? Well, the reason is there became a point where it became profitable to be on social media. So companies came because profits attract businesses, and some of those businesses are personal brands as well. And what people figured out when they broke down the algorithms is that people engage more with polarizing content, with hate. People would rather hear the story that's defamation of character to somebody they already don't like than hear the most recent happy story. That's what they discovered. It's the truth. And then Facebook, of course, figured this out too. In their analytics, they realized that people love hate. So I'm sure you've read those articles lately about how Facebook has been basically pushing up in priority hateful content, right? So that entire piece of social media should be avoided at all costs. If you want to improve your life on social media, stop reading those articles, stop engaging with those articles, leave them alone. The second reason I have a good experience is, well, for one, I'm a content creator, so that makes it a little easier to do this step. But it's posting all the time. So what will happen if you post more on social media is you'll get more touch points with people in your life. And let me explain what I mean by this. You have to be authentic on social media is step one. Because as soon as you're fake or trying to be something or somebody, the engagement that you get on the content that you're making and don't believe in doesn't move you enough to establish relationships with anybody. You almost dislike the people who follow you because you grow to resent the fact that they don't actually like the real you. They just like this thing that you created, okay? So that's a little bit of a cerebral take on it. But the point is, if you post real, authentic moments of your life, things that matter to you, things that give you a real reaction, it can be a show that you're watching, you're hanging out with friends at a party, or something pops in your head and you think it's hilarious, something is cringy, you want to vlog something you're about to do just because it might be interesting to people, post more of that stuff. I know it's not easy for everybody, and it's easier for a content creator because I'm already in that headspace of record it, right? As soon as I think of something, I'm just like, I should just say it. And so that's like what my reels and stuff are, is just like me saying the stuff in the moment that I think about. But if you do more of that, here's what happens. Here's why it's going to enrich your life. What you'll find is that people from your past, who are your friends, people you just met once at a wedding 15 years ago, when you post real stuff about yourself every once in a while, that post is going to be pushed and seen by somebody that you have not talked to in a very long time. And that touch point gives you your friendship a new spark. And this is huge. It's these moments in life that make people happy. There's books written about this. These relationships popping back into your life at random are beautiful. It reminds you what you liked about that person to begin with, because chances are it relates to something that you connected on before. Or it's an interest with this person that you didn't know you had. I start so many conversations with people that I have not seen in 7 years on some obscure subject, even if it's as simple as what TV show I watched on Netflix the other day. You find that you have these sames with people, and you can sit there and freely discuss your sames for an evening sometimes. Like, sometimes you get lost in these conversations on a subject that interests you. Because let's get real. Real people aren't perfectly aligned with us. Even if you're married, it doesn't matter who's in your life and who's around you. You have similar interests and you have different interests. And it's why you don't want to hang out 24/7. It's because you eventually get sick of them and you want to connect with somebody who likes doing that one thing that you like to do that this person that you're with has no interest in doing. So what social media allows you to do is that, from the comfort of your home. It allows you to be fulfilled in all of the little nuances of your personality that you didn't know you could ever connect with a person on. And that is extremely special. That is something that cannot be repeated. That's something that changed the world for the good and never gets recognized. Nobody ever talks about it. And I think that that is just such a shame. Like, I look at relationships. Here's how I view relationships. It is, they're fireflies in the night. And all of your relationships are all there, but they flicker. They're in and out of your life. And that's what social media creates in your world of friendships, is a flickering night sky of touch points on things that matter to you in the moment that you're thinking about them. It's so wildly powerful to be that not alone. It's something that you need to think about. Because if you think about the past and the way that it used to be, you would meet somebody once at random. And if you don't become pen pals or get their phone number and call them regularly for the rest of your life, your friendship ceases to exist. They are not fireflies. They're sparks. And they fade and then they're gone forever. And that's, I think, a sad thing about reality, is friendships die that maybe you don't want to die, or maybe die for a period of time and maybe at some point they're not dead anymore. And social media does that for you. And not only does it do that, it helps you meet new people with the same interests as well. It's not just your friends, because what's going to end up happening, and here's the other absolutely beautiful thing about social media. Algorithms were made for humans. They were made to please people. They exist solely to do so. So if I post something completely obscure, I have just a weird thing that interests me or that I think of, the chances of me knowing somebody in my immediate circle or even my extended circle that resonates with in the slightest is slim. It's unlikely I have a single person to share that moment with. But if you share that moment online, you will find people with that same thought in that same moment. And how cool is that? So that's my advice to you. Just start using it different. I think it can change your life for the better.